Hey, I want to make a fast video because I finally realized something. Now, hopefully, as you know by now, I am a conservative. Now, if you don't like Trump, like you really hate him and you can't stand listening to anything, then please stop playing the video. If you don't like Trump, but you want to know what crazy things I have to say so you control, okay, you're welcome, but you've been warned. I'm being fair. You've been warned. This is an explanation of why people don't like Trump. Now, how this works is it's not that people were ordinary and suddenly Trump came along and they changed. People have been how they have been for a long time. The people who like Trump, unless they've had an ideological change, people have liked Trump for the same reason that they've been who they are for a long time. People that don't like Trump have, that they've been that way for a long time. Now there's this movement, people shift blue and then they shift red, which, that happens. But let's just forget about people changing back and forth. And let's just say that people have always kind of leaned left or always leaned right. They've always leaned liberal or they've always leaned conservative. What's going on with that? Why is it, from the conservative perspective, why is it that people just don't get it? Economy's up, jobs are up. You've got, I mean, the numbers are there. I mean, Trump, he campaigns with people, they win. Congressmen don't want to campaign with them, they lose. The Senate's up, the House is down. That's not an even odd, obvious win for anyone, but people don't get it. What is it? What is it about it that people don't get? I've finally figured it out, and I've got this way to explain it. Imagine with me this illustration to explain my point. An airplane. People are getting on an airplane. Now you've got first class, economy class, business class. You've got different, but they're all getting on the airplane. So they all wait, and then they go through the gate of their ticket, and they walk down to the thing or up the stairs, however it works, and they get on a plane, and the flight attendants are there, and okay, just please sit down. So they sit down, and they turn off their phone, and they buckle their seatbelt, and they watch the event emergency ditching. There are life preservers underneath your seats, and please note the exits at the front of the plane. So they go through that, and then the plane takes off, and it flies. Some nice guy comes on the radio, calls himself the captain. "This is your captain speaking, and we're on our final destination. We're currently flying 3 p.m. Here we're in partly cloudy skies and a little sunny, we're 23 degrees, and it's..." And so, that was 23 degrees Celsius, by the way. So, okay, so they get, and then they approach their destination. After they have a nice meal, they put their trays up, they pull their seats up, they turn their phones off, they buckle their seat belts, and the plane lands. Now, if they were in my illustration, if those people were liberals, they would say, hear me to the end of this. They would argue that the reason the plane flew is because they did those things. They probably complain about the engine. Now, this oftentimes describes the crazy MBA idiot that takes over the company and fires all the good people. It's the same problem with that guy. Why is he that way? It's just the same problem. It's not about your politics, it's about the thinking. So, maybe this is maybe we're describing someone that's pro-Trump, but he's still got this problem. Okay, so this is what's the thinking? This is what it's about. These people, they get on the plane and they think that all those things that they did, waiting in line, sitting, buckling your seatbelt, watch the thing, food up, finished, and seat up, buckle the seatbelt, that makes the plane, because that's what they do. You go to the plane, you do those things, and the plane flies. They think that what they're doing has the causal relationship to their experience. They think that the reason the food comes out is because they pulled their tray out. It's semi kind of narcissism here as far as, thinking that they're the reason that everything happens. It's kind of like how you're driving down the street and there's an idiot and you honk at him and someone else thinks you're honking at them. And it's like, it's not all about you. I mean, everybody isn't driving thinking about you. Maybe I'm honking at someone else. It's like that thing. But they don't understand, back to my illustration, they don't get it that there are at least five industries that make this plane fly that they don't even see. You've got the engineers, the theory on aeronautics, how airplanes should work, the theory of it all. Then you've got building the plane. That's a whole other study to build them correctly once you've got the designs. Now, oftentimes the same company, but it's two different fields of study. Then you've got the whole experience in maintaining these planes. They have to be rebuilt regularly to keep them very, very safe. Then you've got the whole career of learning how to fly these machines. That's a whole other study. Each of these could have its own series of journals, academic journals, and lots of people with PhDs working on how to do these different things. Then you've got the whole topic of air traffic control, making sure these planes don't crash into each other on the ground and in the air. So you've got all these different industries that make this plane fly, but the passengers don't see any of it. They for all they know, the captain is just a weatherman. Because that's what he talks about. He talks about what time it is, if they're going to be late or early, what time it is when they land, if you should change your watches, and what the weather is. I mean, that's, and he's this nice man who smiles. I mean, that's great PR. So we've got these people who live their lives, and they go through life, and they think that there are certain things that are just always there. They're just always there. Why does the plane crash? Is it because of a problem with air traffic control, problem with the flight crew? Is there a problem with the maintenance crew? Is there a problem with communication between captains and co-pilots? I mean, that's, you know, Malcolm Gladwell talked about that's a reason. They don't think about that. Oh, sometimes it happens. And they don't understand that there are these industries with lots of work and lots of people working hard and tirelessly to make everything keep going as it is and to be, hopefully be better in the future, and that's why things are the way they are and why they're always the way they are, because of these hard-working, hard-thinking people, and they're unaware of that. They think that the part that they see is all that there is. So then we come along, we start talking about the need to cut regulations, or we start talking about how we should make the laws work the right way. And the people who don't get it, they think that what they see and what they do is the cause and essence of everything, that there's nothing going on to sustain these things that are somehow always there. So we start talking about the mechanics of law and country and economy and security and safety at home and crime rates. And they think that we're joking or that we're selling something. They don't see that there's a causal relationship. They think that certain things are always going to be there. Okay, now part two of this, part two, when you run into one of these people and you start telling them, no, there's a whole industry there and we have to manage that part of the job correctly. The captain actually controls a plane, you know, like, you know, and he's got to go to school. He's got to be awake and ethical and have a good work ethic and do a good job or we crash and die. If you say that to one of these guys, it's like they all talk in the same way. It's like they get taken over by this telepathic satellite AI in orbit, and their face goes the same, and they start talking with the same tone. They do this condescension, and they go like this, and they all do the same thing. It's going to be fine. People are worrying just way too much. It's going to be there. It always figures itself out. You're worrying too much. That's just ridiculous. You're just complaining too much. Another one of these turkeys that did this was Flake. I do believe it was Flake. Trump recently said, he resigned because of me. He said that at his press conference, of this guy. I went and read his letter. It went to the Washington Post in the afternoon of the election day. And the way this guy talks is, I'm like, he's not saying anything. It's just, how could we do that? It's like the video, would you just look at that? I mean, that's all he said. I mean, people talk this way. Huh. And I just, we can't do that. That's not how to, can we grow up? But grow up about what? You were only concerned about how people talk? Trump is only a personality cult because the mechanics and theories and industries about how to make stuff work he's talking about is all just silliness, because the plane's just automatically going to take off if we sit in the seat at the right time. That's what's going on. And whether what I'm saying is true for what's going on or whether I'm just blowing smoke, that is really the ideological difference that splits people in all kinds of philosophies and in how to run a business and what's going on in the local religion or social group or whatever it is, or the company, what's wrong with the company, the social culture problems inside Google, what's going on here, or especially politics. What's really going on is this ideology. Are there things that are just always going to be there? Does money grow on trees? Is there a cow out there you go out to every morning and go, and the money just comes out? Well, even a cow you got to feed and take care of. Even if the money grows on the trees, you got to go out and bring it in. It doesn't just magically materialize into your wallet. People work hard to make things happen, and there's a right way and a wrong way, and then a hopefully soon to be learned and found out better way. And there's how hard we work. There's a hard working way and a lazy way. There's a whole proper way of doing things, and that's why things are held up. And some people just don't believe that.